I bring you greetings from the Door Center, located in America's paradise, the United States Virgin Islands. On behalf of the Virgin Islands, we wish you to continue safe distancing and, of course, stay safe. My name is Richard Dixon. I'm your host for this program as the Kennedy Center presents Arts Across America, featuring our very own Stanley and the 10 Sleepless Nights from our beautiful island of St. Croix in the U.S. Virgin Islands. This year, Stanley and the 10 Sleepless Nights celebrates 50 years of representing and promoting Virgin Islands art, culture, and music throughout the world and their tireless contributions to the United States Virgin Islands. Stanley and the 10 Sleepless Nights began their journey in the love of Cajun music. The merry musical group of childhood friends got together in the late 60s, early 70s, and in the early 70s, that's when the name went household, went viral. Now, Stanley and the 10 Sleepless Nights, even though they've dedicated themselves to the preservation of indigenous music and culture, they have, through the versatility of its members, diversified its repertoire to include music of almost every Caribbean flavor and some American music as well. As a result, this is the band of choice for quadrille dances, senior citizen functions and socials, educational, civic, community, tourism, cultural representations. You say it, they have done it. In addition, they have played for many dances, concerts, fundraisers, and of course, the fantastic festivals that's held throughout the Caribbean that have been invited to as well. Now, in January of 2006, Stanley and the 10 Sleepless Nights played at the Virgin Islands Department of Tourism's exposition in Grand Central Station, New York. Now, while there, they appeared on both Good Morning America and Fox News. Now, some of the places that Stanley and the 10 Sleepless Nights have promoted the Virgin Islands music are to places like the Smithsonian Institute, the Folklife Festival, that's of course in Washington, D.C., Independence Day Parade in Washington, D.C., the New Orleans AFT Convention, the Miami Cultural Presentation, St. Kitts Carrier Fest, Totola Music Festival, and in 2005, Stanley and the 10 Sleepless Nights played at two of Totola's International Village Festivals. And of course, they have toured Denmark over four times. Now, Stanley and the 10 Sleepless Nights do more than just promote our culture and our music. They are truly involved in our community. Now, Stanley and the 10 Sleepless Nights have established a nonprofit organization, a 501(c) entity, and that foundation is to award scholarships and to graduating high school seniors intending to go to college and major in music. In addition, three of our former members are also TSA scholarship recipients and now teachers in our schools. Ladies and gentlemen, on behalf of the Kennedy Center, the Door Center, I present to you Stanley and the 10 Sleepless Nights. Now, let's understand how we listen to our music, our Quail Bay music. It tells a story. So before every song, we'd be letting you know exactly a little something about it, but you got to listen to the lyrics to really catch the depth and meaning of the song. Well, our first song is Celie Bell. Now, Wailing is a Cajun adjective that describes a girl who does lick boat all over the place. No, Rolling Stone, she got his new moss. So she maga in her face, she narrow around her waist, and still handling the father, the son, and the extra married man, Lord Harry the judge, and even the big tone policeman on the corner. Ladies and gentlemen, Celie Bell. Thank you.
and shy beach to hold the girl. Chili bell, oh chili bell, oh your wild and chili bell, where you get shy beach to hold the girl. It was the father and the son, and the other married man, where you get shy beach to hold the girl. The father and the son, and the extra married man, where you get shy beach to hold the girl. Chili bell, oh chili bell, where you wild and chili bell, where you get shy beach to hold the girl. Chili bell, oh chili bell, the wild and chili bell, where you get shy beach to hold the girl.
Special thing they like to eat in the morning. Well, they like to have in the morning. Now, if you're good, you'll get it once. You're very good, you get it twice. And if your belly ain't too full, you'll get it three times. Everybody know what morning juice is.
I want some more.
so sweet, I want some more, give me some more. My name too so sweet, I want some more, give me some more. Come girl, let me go another rum. Come with the blue madam. Come girl, let me go another rum. I tell them my name too so sweet.
Official and traditional dance of the United States Virgin Islands, which originated in France in the 1700s. Now, although the United States Virgin Islands is a U.S. territory, through its history, the islands have been part of several different nations, including France and England. Quadrille was brought to the Virgin Islands during the height of its popularity in England and was adopted as plantation entertainment. Quadrilles were originally performed by two couples. The dance later evolved, and two more couples were added to form sides. Now, the dance at that time was performed by four couples in a square and is a precursor to traditional square dancing that you see in the South. Now, the dance has continued to evolve over the past few centuries as it takes on a unique and dynamic presentation and personality when performed in the U.S. Virgin Islands. As the dancers perform, the dancers are told what particular moves to perform by the floor master, or the caller in this case. Much like traditional square dance, in quadrille, however, many of the calls are given in French. For example, when the caller says, balancez, the given in French, the gentlemen will move from their partner's side and then position themselves directly in front of their partner. And when the caller says Tunez, the gentleman will place his palm on the lady's left side and turn to her right. The basic step that you see the dancers performing is called polka. The dancers will wear traditional quadrille costumes made of Madras material. And in the Virgin Islands, the men wear Madras shirts and the women wear Madras skirts, traditionally with white petticoats. The women wear head ties in the same art of the Virgin Islands. This is because the configuration of the head tie can have great significance or meaning related to a woman's social status. I am free, as one head tie style may point out. And a head tie, as you will note, always has two points. I'm engaged, but I can still try. A head tie with three points, well, I'm already taken, and 4 points means I'm available. And there's no 4-point ladies here, just so you'll know. So, ladies and gentlemen, I present to you the II Cultural Dancers.
Thank you.
Cultural Dances right out of here, beautiful St. Croix in the U.S. Virgin Islands. The IA Cultural Dance Company, Inc. was an organization that began 10 years ago as a friendly gesture to appease a friend who wanted a truly cultural, traditional wedding ceremony. Now, a group of friends came together and they danced the well-known dance of the Virgin Islands, which is the quadrille. And as the seed was planted, many wanted to continue this gesture and continue to grow with a group now known as IA Cultural Dancers Company, Inc. The primary purpose of the organization is to maintain and promote the culture of the U.S. Virgin Islands. The literature includes dance, music, masquerades, and all other cultural aspects. Many of the members are from the Senior High School Emancipation Dancers, which is a direct impact from their collaborative work with Stanley and the 10 Sleepless Nights. The organization has a total of 30 plus members. Now, you know what I told you in the beginning? That you really have to listen to the words of Quailby. Now, I hope that last presentation that we saw inspired those folks viewing to kick a heel, dance up, because we know you miss your live quadrille. Come home. We're waiting for you with open arms. Now, this is something that, another thing that everybody must have in their house. Now, from what I've learned, Pussy Whiskers is nothing tastes better than that. But once you put it in your soup is off the hook. Ladies and gentlemen, Pussy Whiskers.
Thank you.
I need your help. No, seriously, I need your help. Now, I'm looking for my nano because I miss her and I want her and I don't know where past she gone. Please help me find my nano.
Thank you.
All right, folks. As they would say, it's time to get busy. Everybody on your feet. Yes, I'm speaking to you. Why? Because no more toe tapping, no more head nodding in rhythm. It's time to dance. Ladies and gentlemen, this is Percy Sweatdown. Tantalizer is my new girl. Wait, what are you telling me? She not here. Where she gone? She went east side? I'll go, oh, don't go east. I'm going west side. No, don't go west. She like the bay side, yes? I don't get my trunks, I'm going bay side. We going, no? So what she gone out of this place for? What do you mean she gone to be with her man them? Lord Harry the judge. Tantalizer.
Come to your potion, I can't.
Yes, the two of them left me. They got about their business. But now you're going to bring Aunt Mary to me? You hear about Aunt Mary? Jeez, boy, if you don't run from Aunt Mary and she hold you, she just might shave you and you don't need a beard. Ladies and gentlemen, Aunt Mary. Thank you. The question around the Virgin Islands is about this lady who, for some reason, decide she gonna be with her legally recognized brother-in-law. But the question people ask is not how that happened. The question that they asking Sophie Benjamin. That child you got on your hip. What that child supposed to call you? Auntie? Mommy? What? Ladies and gentlemen, Sophie Benjamin.
Your love for brother-in-law. Orange Sophie Benjamin, Sophie of Benaki, but your love for brother-in-law. The child in your hand, I will call your auntie and then turn back, call your brother-in-law. The pinky in your hand, I will call your auntie and then turn back, call your brother-in-law.
Official music of the United States Virgin Islands is a vocal and instrumental musical style, a product of country life in the U.S. Virgin Islands. It is a reflection of the rural and rustic character of the environment in which the creators lived. Quail Bay musicians were self-taught, played homemade instruments, and lived and worked on the sugar plantations in the country. When enslaved, Africans was forbidden to practice their music and dance, Over a period of time, they gradually began to listen and copy the music and dance of the slave masters. The restrictions imposed by the European slave masters that led to the transformation of the original rituals, music, and dances, it has led to the creation of a new music and musical style. Over time, as Quelbe bands evolved, so did instrumentation, but the strong African rhythms remained constant. Quelbe music is known for its emphasis on percussive and rhythmic patterns, with often just vocals or a lead instrument such as a flute, sax, violin, or accordion playing the lead or melody. While the instruments may have changed, the pulsating beats have remained the same infectious musical patterns that still forces everyone to dance. Quelbe music is dance music, or is often described to many, it's happy music. I know the juice is just there. Come on home. We welcome you with open arms. The Kennedy Center presents Arts Across America, featuring Stanley and the 10 Sleepless Nights. Folks, thank you for viewing. Thank you for watching. Thank you to the Door Center for having us here. Stay safe, folks.